My name is Melissa. I am 30 years old and I wear a hooded sweatshirt day and night, whether it's 90 degrees outside or 90 below outside, because I have a huge lump on my back and neck. Back in 2015, the summer of 2015, I noticed a lump growing on my shoulder. It was half an inch, easy to cover. Progressively started getting bigger. A year later, it was the size of a grapefruit. And now it has tripled in size. Just feels squishy, you know, moves around. Then it's just growing bigger this way and down. When I'm laying down, it is pushed up and acts as an extra pillow. I just thought that it would go away eventually, and it just got bigger and bigger. To see that it has grown so much, I don't know if it's gonna stop or if it's just gonna keep doubling in size as the years go on. So it is scary. At the beginning, I would be sleeping and it would feel like my whole arm was asleep and I wasn't sleeping on it. I thought it was like pinching a nerve or something. I went to a general physician doctor. She said that it was not something they could remove, that there's too many nerves there, and suggested I see a plastic surgeon. I had the plastic surgeon take a look at it. He said that we needed to remove it with surgery, but I didn't have the ability to get off work for weeks. It just wasn't something that I was able to do. These are ringing up $1.15.
Okay.
So manually ring them in to 99 cents.
Okay.
And then I'll switch them tomorrow. I'm always pulling at my sweater. What in the world? If I pull it up and over, it kind of covers it more. Is that it for you? But yeah, I always feel like everyone's staring. I am finally here at Dr. Lee's office, and I am very nervous. My biggest fear is that it will be too big for her, and she won't be able to remove it.
When I see patients that have big growths, that certainly is concerning to me because I don't know whether this is something that I can treat in my office. I really can't make any decisions until I examine her.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. I'm Sandra, Dr. Lee.
Melissa.
Nice to meet you. Welcome.
Thank you.
What's going on? What are you here for?
I have this mask here.
I see it a little bit around your shoulder there.
Yeah.
How long have you had that?
3 years.
Well, that must mean like it's kind of growing overnight almost.
Yeah, it definitely has gotten bigger and bigger, faster and faster.
And all of a sudden it's so big, you're like, you have to actually physically hide it and things.
Yeah.
You actually cover it up pretty well. I wouldn't really necessarily know until you point it out to me.
Yeah, I wear hoodies all day and all night, warm or cold.
The fact that it grew so quickly in the last 3 years is a little bit suspicious.
All right, my hands are freezing.
When something grows really quickly, that can be something that we physicians pay attention to. Does that mean that there's something bad there that's growing out of control?
Yeah, girl, you got a pretty big lipoma here, hon.
Melissa most likely has a lipoma, which is a benign collection of fat cells. It's as if one fat cell just divided upon itself and created clonal copies.
I'm trying to see how solid it feels, because a lot of times the lipomas are its own little thing, so it can kind of pop out. And that's when they're nice and easy to do.
Because Melissa's lipoma is so large, I really have to look at how much numbing I can use, whether it's safe to do this under local anesthesia.
Even though this is so big, it's really sitting above everything. You know, it's on top of your muscle. It's like almost, it's like essentially like your little pillow, you know? I think that we can do this under local anesthesia, okay?
I am nervous about being awake for the surgery. It kind of grosses me out. I mean, I don't want to be put to sleep, but I don't want to see it.
There's always a chance that this is somewhere that's winding under something that I don't want to get any closer to, or that I don't feel like it's the proper way to do this, I would stop. There's a chance that we might start doing this and, you know, I don't finish it. Okay, but I'm gonna try my best.
Okay.
Melissa's lipoma has various lobes to it. So I suspect it's sort of finding its way around to any free space under the skin. And that's concerning to me.
Now my cold hands, I gotta draw on you first.
I'm just hoping for the best right now. I'm not trying to think about the maybes.
So let me get you a little more comfortable. We gotta find the right position for you first. And then the first thing we're gonna do is numb the area, okay?
I'm going to use local anesthesia to numb up Melissa's lipoma.
It is in an awkward area. That's the main thing for you. Right up against your neck.
You always have to be conscious about where you are in the body. You know where those muscles are, where those nerves are, where those blood vessels are, and make sure you're not going in somewhere that you shouldn't, especially with something so big.
Hey, just make sure I'm never hurting you, okay?
Okay.
Just make sure nothing's ever sharp or uncomfortable. Nothing's ever sharp.
This is the largest lipoma that I've ever attempted to remove. It is huge.
Look at this lipoma. He's ready to come out.
I'm working on Melissa's lipoma, and with my first incision, it actually made me happy. It's like it pushes its way out. You just make one little cut with your scalpel blade, and it's like it's coming out at you. You don't always know whether they're going to behave, but that initial cut can tell you a lot.
I just gotta slowly ease it. Are you okay?
Yeah.
What's up?
Oh, it hurts a little bit.
Okay, it hurts because I'm tugging on you.
I can feel Dr. Lee pulling on my insides. It's so uncomfortable.
Let me just back off a little bit. Let me see if I can pull it up this way.
When you're numbed locally, we are stopping the pain fibers from firing and going to your brain and telling you that you're experiencing pain. But it's not affecting nerves of vibration, even nerves that are a sense cold or hot. So you can feel that tugging, but you don't feel pain.
Sweetie, hold on, I'm getting it. He's just making me work for it. I know I'm pulling on you down deep, but as long as it's not sharp, it should be okay. It's coming. It's like having a baby. I'm trying to get him out of one piece, and he's coming. Just gentle, womanly touch. I might have to take him off in pieces just because I think he's too big. All right, I gotta cut this off. This is too big here. I can't pull the whole thing out one. Yeah, I'm gonna call myself the Lipoma Whisperer after you. Uh-huh. All right, I think it's about half, maybe? Yours is a workout, girl. Uh-huh. And you wouldn't think there was more. So now it's just like the last little tendrils, and if I don't try to get it all, I'm afraid it'll come back, and we don't want to do this again, right?
No.
Okay, we're getting it. Come on. You got it, we got it all!
All right.
I'm gonna weigh this one for sure. Okay, let's fix you up. Anna, you know what? I made a smaller hole.
I'm really happy that we got this lipoma out of Melissa safely and entirely because it's gonna change your life.
Grab her a mirror. Just here, I'm gonna hold your head.
Oh my gosh.
Like, she's gonna stare at herself all the time. She's gonna find out while we're getting ready. Why not?
That's
you deserve
crazy.
It. It looks good.
It does. I was definitely shocked when I first saw myself.
Girl. I can see your whole head now. You don't have a head behind your head.
Yeah, I need a pillow right here. I knew it was coming off, but it's gone.
Look at this beautiful neckline you got there,
yeah.
Girl.
Yeah. Literally a weight has been lifted off my shoulders. It feels good to have this gone.
Okay, you want to see it?
Yeah.
It's right here. You want to lift it up? Lift it up.
Oh my gosh. I would say that's a bowling ball size.
Yeah, it could be. It's all piled on top.
Oh my God, that is gross. I feel like a little girl, like Christmas Day, opening presents.
How much do you think it's gonna weigh? Oh wow, that is gonna take the cake. Three. I'm gonna give it an even 3. Dang girl, you got a lipoma, let me just tell you. Here, hold it like this and see if you feel it's 3.
It feels like more than that, but yeah. This was definitely one of the best days of my life. My sweatshirt, no, it's gone. I don't have anything to cover up anymore.
Looks good.